Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy, and today's video I am going to be answering a question that I get quite a bit, and I got it in my last video that I posted of KASHI'S cage change as well, and that is what substrates that I use in her cage, and I use quite a variety of different ones, so I'm just going to go through the list and show you guys the bag of the product so that you can see what it looks like and hopefully find it in the store if you're interested. So the first substrate I will talk about is the sand that I use. This is from Home Depot. It is the Sacrete brand. I don't know if I said that the right way, but it is like $4.97 for a 50-pound bag, and it lasts a very, very long time. It is so cost-efficient to get something like this. Now, a lot of people ask if you have to wash this before you use it, and I personally have never done so, and I don't really see the point in doing it because it does say right on the bag, it says that it's graded, washed, dried, and sanitized. So I don't do anything. I will use it straight from the bag. Now, just a little tip, if you notice that the sand inside of your bag is wet or damp and clumped together, what you'll want to do is scoop it out. You can put it on like a flat pan and just leave it in the house under air conditioner for like a couple days or so. Then when you go to use it, it'll be dry and it'll be smooth and it won't be like all clumped together. So that's just a little tip for you guys. The next substrate that I use that I get a lot of questions about is this Eco Earth bedding, and this is just ground up coconut fiber that is perfectly safe to use for hamsters. Now, this is sold in the reptile section of a pet store, but it's kind of the consistency of it is somewhat similar to soil, I think, but it doesn't have fertilizers or chemicals or any of that stuff that oftentimes you will find in soil bags. So I prefer to use this over soil, and I've never had a problem with it. Now, I do recommend that you freeze this bag before you use it, just to make sure that there's no mites or anything like that. There shouldn't be, but it's always better to be safe than sorry. So I do suggest freezing this before you use it. This stuff is excellent for a hamster to dig around in. I will say it does not hold burrows at all, so please don't use it for the entire cage for your hamster because they won't be able to, you know, create burrows that won't collapse. So you do want to use another type of bedding besides this, but this is nice for like a little corner of the cage or perhaps a jar. So the next substrate that I incorporate in my cage is another type of coconut fiber, but this is actually a coconut fiber bark rather than being ground up fine like the Eco Earth was. So this stuff is a tiny bit like pokey, I guess. I mean, it's kind of like aspen bedding. So I like to use this in a small area of the cage just to add a little bit of texture, but I don't like using it in large areas because it is not the softest to walk on. So in KASHI'S recent cage change, I gave her a ceramic dish that had some of these round ball looking things in it. It's like a hamster ball pit kind of, and this is the KT soft granule bedding, and I really love this stuff. It is so fun to dig around in, and it's pretty soft as well. My hamsters, I've used it with Carob and KASHI, and both of them really, really love to dig around in it. So I think this is another bedding that is worth incorporating in your cage. You can do it in, you know, a corner if you want, or you can put it in a pot, but make sure that you have quite a bit where they can dig around in it. So the bedding in front of the wheel is KT Clean and Cozy. It is extremely soft and it also holds burrows very well. Now obviously KASHI doesn't burrow in the section here, but it is soft, so I like to put that for when she steps off of the wheel. And this is the camo color. Another one that I also use is the KT Apple Orchard color, and this is like a red color, and It reminded me of little flowers or herbs or something. So usually what I will do is I'll just take a small handful of this and sprinkle it in certain sections, and it looks like flowers to me. So this isn't something that I incorporate a lot of. Now, I did want to mention, because this bedding is red, I would not suggest using it in your hamster's nest area. With female hamsters especially, sometimes they can have bleeding coming from their bottom, and it would be pretty difficult to tell since this bedding is red. It would just blend right in. I suggest just using this bedding as sprinkling little pieces here and there to look like flowers, but definitely not using it where your hamster sleeps. So the main bedding that I fill KASHI'S cage with is a hardwood bedding, and it is called aspen. And I get a lot of people who get confused and think that aspen is a unsafe bedding, and aspen is actually safe. It is pine and cedar bedding that is not. Now, I like to use aspen bedding in very large cages especially because it is a bit less expensive than some of the other types of bedding, and you can buy a huge bag on Amazon, and it is good for filling up cages that are this size. So I also have to say I like how it looks, and I also really like how it smells. It smells nice and woodsy and fresh when I dump it in the cage. So something that I like to sprinkle on top of my aspen to make it look more like grass and also to make it softer to walk on is I like to sprinkle some orchard hay over it. And this is a bag that I got from Vitacraft, and I was feeling the different bags, and this one said that it was soft stemmed, and it also felt very soft to me. If you use hay, you do want to make sure that you're able to squeeze it in your hand and that it doesn't feel sharp. Occasionally a hamster may try to put hay in their cheek pouch to take it back to their nest, and you do want to be careful that they don't, you know, puncture their cheek pouch with something that's really pokey. So always go with a soft stemmed type of hay and make sure that you can squeeze it in your hand and that it feels soft. So another bedding that I love to incorporate in my cage themes is Carefresh, of course, and you guys know I've done a lot of videos for Carefresh. I love their blue especially. I love to put that in little like reptile watering dishes to make it look like it's a pond, or to use it to make streams in the cage, you know, streams of water. So this stuff is great for adding some color in your cage and also looking like a realistic little water section. It's great for beach and ocean themed cages as well. So lastly, another bedding that I really like to incorporate is this brown eco crinkle bedding, and these are just brown crinkles of paper, and they are pretty soft, but again, they're not like, they don't hold burrows or anything all that well. So I like to sprinkle this and make little pathways, and it looks very much like dirt, but yet it doesn't make quite as much mess as like using dirt or eco earth. So I think that is everything that I use in my cage for substrates, and if you guys have any other questions that I didn't cover, feel free to leave them in the comments below. But it really does bring out their natural behaviors to include substrates, various textures and such in the cage. It's just so much fun to watch them digging around and stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!